Hey everyone, Jackson here with Royal Botanical Gardens. Wanting to talk to you about a special thing that a lot of urban cores have as part of its infrastructure, and those are alleys. I love alleys. I've been walking through alleys since I was a little kid because there's lots to see, lots to do, and there's no shortage of plant life that can occur in an alleyway. And most of the times, hey, it could be good, it could be a native plant, but it could also be the spot for an invasive species. And I've got something here that is an invasive species that I want you to keep your eyes out for, because in springtime, it's emerging, it's here. It's really easy to identify, and now is the time to identify it. Garlic mustard. So how do you know you even have garlic mustard in the first place? Well, the first thing you're gonna look for is a cluster. Cluster. So they're growing together in a cluster here. And the leaves are kind of shaped a little bit like hearts, which is a little bit endearing, if it wasn't so awful. And then, almost these nice little bumps around the outside of it. It's a cool looking plant. Another good way to know if you have garlic mustard growing on your property is to use iNaturalist. So if you haven't used iNaturalist before, it's a pretty cool app. You would take a picture of the plant and you would want to make sure you're capturing a good amount of it, especially the leaves or the bark or the stems or the flowers, anything like that. And then as you submit it, it will likely tell you that it's garlic mustard, or someone else will, especially if it's a plant you don't even know what it is. Take a picture of it. iNaturalist is awesome for that. Another way is actually to rip a little piece of it. Give it a little sniff. Does it have a little garlicky, mustardy smell to it? Can you eat it? Yes, you can. So not only should you be ripping this out of the ground, but you can actually cook with this. Some neat recipes out there where you can make like a garlic pesto sauce. So when you rip it out, it's not like you just chuck it away. You can actually use it for your own benefit, which is kind of cool. Now, say you have a lot of it and you don't really want to eat it, they don't suggest that you throw it in your compost or your green bin. In fact, it's needed to die. So you have to almost put it in your garbage bag and steal it. So that way it doesn't escape, it doesn't continue to thrive at all. So if you are to uproot it, put it into your garbage bag and get rid of it totally that way. But it is super invasive. Like I mentioned, it's growing along this wall here. It's growing in a few other spots. So in your alleyways, in your backyards, in your garden, if you're noticing garlic mustard, this is the time to get rid of it now, especially before it flowers. It's really easy to identify. It's super green right now, super lush, and that's part of it being invasive. It just takes a stranglehold right away before anything else can get out there. Its roots are even toxic. Its roots kill other plant roots, gets them away, more room for the garlic mustard. So don't just rip it out like this. Get it right from its roots. There we go. And get it out of the ground. That's garlic mustard for you. Till next time, stay golden.